Good morning, dear children. Hope all have read section 1. My sister. Now, what happened in section 1? Here you find that a brother, Nilu, is coming to call Choten, his sister, from Delhi, isn't it? She is coming from Delhi after 4 months. So, she is coming to, Nilu is coming to call his sister. Now, we go on to section 2. Now, before we go on to section 2, you see on page 57, two questions given there. Listen to your teacher read the section and discuss these in the class, isn't it? The three qualities Nilu missed about his sister. What are the qualities that he uses to describe his sister? We can say that he is telling his sister is very courageous, his sister is very determined, and she has got a good presence of mind. Very courageous. What is the example for courageous shown there? That is, she is telling her mother, nobody should come with me, I will go alone. And once she makes up her mind to do something, she would not allow anybody to change her mind. That is, she was a very determined woman or determined girl. And the third one, her presence of mind. You remember when the train met with an accident, she did not cry, she did not get confused. She decided to walk to the nearest shop, borrowed a bicycle and attended the interview. That shows her presence of mind, her ability to react quickly, change an order with the surroundings. Now section 2, there was the usual rush and bustle everywhere. You remember when a train arrives in a station, yes, there will be a great noise, a crowd, people will be rushing this side and that side. Some people will be coming down, getting down from the bogies. People will be, relatives will be waiting for their arrival. I went and stood before the ladies' compartment. In every train there is a ladies' compartment, isn't it? Since the girl coming by the train was a lady, she was normally she was travelling in the ladies' compartment. There were just two passengers there, my sister and an old lady. So he was surprised to see that there were only two passengers in that ladies' compartment. That is, one was his sister and the other one was an old lady. It seemed totally incredible that a train coming from Delhi could possibly have such an empty compartment. So he was really surprised or confused or did not believe that a train which was coming from Delhi had only two passengers in the compartment. It was all empty. The two of them must have had a real cozy journey, sleeping all the way. So he thought they were very comfortable. These two ladies were there in the compartment. So they must have spent the time sleeping or lying down very comfortable in the compartment. My sister held the old lady's hand and helped her alight from the train. In the picture you can see his sister is holding the old lady's hand to help her to get down from the train. Alight from the train means to get down from the train. I took charge of my sister's suitcase and bedding. In the picture you can see the brother is standing with the suitcase in one hand and the bedding in the other hand, her bed. My sister called me and said, "Here, Nilu, come and touch her feet. She is my elder sister, you know, my Baro Didi." So what did the girl tell her? She told her brother, "Come here, come and touch her feet." That is, come and touch the old lady's feet and get her blessings. "She is my elder sister, you know, and what is the name? My Baro Didi." I was quite astonished. Astonished means surprised. I had just one sister. I had never in my life heard of any other sister. So he was surprised because he had only one sister and that sister was standing before him. So he is thinking, I have never heard of any other sisters. My mother did not tell me anything about any other sisters. The old lady had snow white hair and a winsome smile. Winsome means a very pleasant, a charming smile. And she had white hair, just like the snow. Her hair is compared to, white hair is compared to the snow. She must belong to some famous family, I thought, for two men in khaki uniform had come to receive her and see to her luggage. So this boy thought that she is coming from a very rich and famous family, because there were two people dressed in khaki coming to bring her down from the train and carry all her luggage. She had a lovely cane basket in her hand, which she did not hand over to anybody. So in the picture you can see she is having a cane basket, a basket made of cane in her hand, which she did not give it to anyone to hold. I felt sure that it must contain her jewelry. So he thought this box, this cane basket, contained all her jewelry, ornaments. I bent down and touched her feet just as my sister had asked me to do. So the boy Nilu obeyed his sister. He touched the old lady's feet, and what did the old lady do? She laid a hand on my head and blessed me aloud, saying, "Live long and be brave." So that is how the old lady blessed Nilu, by telling him, "Live long and be brave." Then she turned to my sister and said, "Why don't both of you come with me? I have my car here." So she is calling the brother and sister to come with her in her car. So what did Nilu say? I said, "But our father's office car is also here." So he had come in here, in his father's office car. So he said, "Our car is also here." "Well then, so long," she said. Then she said to my sister, "I hope you'll remember all I've been telling you." So she looked at the girl and said, she told his sister, "Don't forget all the things I have told you." My sister replied, "Oh yes, Baro Didi, I'll remember everything, and I'll definitely see you when you come to Delhi again." So she said, "I will never forget what you told me, about what all we talked. I will never forget anything, and I will come to see you when you come to Delhi again." The moment we got into our car, I asked my sister who the old lady was. So when they got inside the car, Nilu asked Choten, his sister, "Who's the old lady?" She only said, "My elder sister." The very next moment she asked me, "By the way, Nilu, have you any idea where one can buy cobras?" So the next question that she asked was, "Have you any idea from where we can buy cobras?" I was startled. He was very much startled. He was very much surprised. Had I heard her right? He thought he had made a mistake in hearing the question. "What did you say?" I asked again. "By what?" "Cobras," said my sister simply, as if it was the most normal request in the world. So she said that sentence, that question, "From where can we buy cobras?" in a normal way, as though asking for, "Can I buy a bag?" or "Can I buy a dress?" It was as simple as that. "What on earth do you want cobras for?" So the boy is asking her, "Why do you want cobras? For what reason do you want the cobras?" "I want to buy one, buy it and tame it." So I want to buy one and tame it. I want to keep it as my pet. I want it to obey me. "What? Tame a real live snake?" My sister burst out laughing and said, "Why not? They are pretty useful creatures." So she is telling, the boy was very surprised. "How can you tame a real live snake?" he is asking her. "Why not? They are pretty useful creatures." She said, "They are very useful creatures. They are pretty also." I was absolutely certain my sister had gone batty. Batty means crazy, a little mad. Or perhaps there was something wrong with my ears. I put my fingers in both my ears and shook my head vigorously. So he was not sure whether he had heard the correct question, or he wondered whether something was wrong with my ear, or whether my sister had gone mad after she had got the job in Delhi. So what did he do? "I put both my fingers in my ears and shook my head vigorously." Vigorously means very strongly, from this side and that side, from one side to the other. "Work in pairs and answer these questions." What were the three things that surprised Nilu? Yes, one is she's when her sister told him that this is my elder sister, he was surprised. Then the second thing, from where we can buy a cobra. And the third thing, she wants to tame a cobra. Now, why did Nilu think the old lady belonged to a famous family? Nilu thought that the old lady belonged to a famous family because she had two people to look after her, dressed in khaki uniform. She had a car. So he thought he was a rich. The old lady was very rich and belonged to a very famous family. So our section 2 ends here, children. Read well, study all the new words given. Thank you.